Okay, welcome to another episode of Draw and Talk, which is a poorly thought out name with a good idea behind it. So essentially, it is what it is. I draw and talk as I'm talk through my ideas as I'm going. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to get right into it. This is a 10-minute sketch, two-handed 10-minute sketch. This is something I do that I enjoy. It's fun. It feels like it's electrifying a part of my brain when I do the two-handed sketches. I have no idea what I'm going to draw as of yet. I have the clock lined up and we're going to get right into it. Let's begin. All right, so I never know which side of the, which arm to go with first. So what I, okay. How do I do this? What I think I'm seeing here is a person looking through a magnifying glass. Not super original or anything, but nonetheless. Something fun and different. And, you know, for me, it's what is the idea that pops in your head as you get going? Grab that and go. If you follow me on Twitter, I made a post today about creative ideas if you are stuck, and that pertains to anything. If you're a writer, if you are a pencil artist like me, you make videos, people can tend to get creatively stuck. And I think timer exercises, meaning things that you time, are always great ways of forcing creativity. Okay, so I'm not thinking, and that's a problem. I'm talking too much about things that I'm not drawing. So let's do that. Okay, so I got a guy sitting here cool. He's got his leg up. He's kind of leaned on the ground. He is looking at something. Now, I don't really like this angle. It's too straight up. The magnifying glass, you want it to be bent a little forward. One way to do that is to expose the top of the glass to give it that illusion of angle, because everything is an illusion, essentially, when you're drawing. So then we can have the back going this way. This should go here. Shorten that up so it makes it looks like it's leaning a little bit more. His eye is much bigger in the magnifying glass. Again, I'm sorry. I'm talking too much. I'm not thinking about which hand I'm working with. That needs to stop. Oops, that ear is up too high. Remember, top of the eye to the bottom of the nose. Okay, so 7 minutes, 22 seconds. We got our initial sketch down. We got our initial idea. So now we can build it. So, what is this person, however, staring at? I don't want it to be just you. Let's have it be somebody here. So I'll make a very quick outline, very simple. Maybe it's like a wizard. So he's got his staff. And this guy is checking out the wizard. Wizards and his long hair. And maybe this is what. All right, so let's erase some of this so we can see what we clearly have and what needs to be strengthened. So that eyeball, let's make it down here a little bit. This nice big eyeball that's doing things here. Now, right now, I'm drawing with two B pencils, a B in each hand. And I have a 4B and a 6B to jump into when I want to add these dark layers. Let's make this person's hand bigger. Because the closer they are to you, the bigger things appear just like the mirror in Cars say. Not worried about the face, how nice it looks. I'm worried about the idea. Let's get the idea down. Let's practice understanding where things are. You know, it's always been about perfection for me, and I am trying very hard to get away from that. Not that I'm ever going to stop doing realism drawings, because I love those. But to become a better artist, I must try different things. I must push myself to break new barriers, to push the envelope on what I'm learning. And I've definitely become a lot better artist. So now I feel like I'm repeating. So I'm repeating things, and I don't want to. So I'm getting bored. That's what that means. I'm repeating lines because I'm bored of what I'm creating. So that means I must. Let's start giving them some details. So we'll split this page in half from here on. Everything on the left side of the page is left-handed. Everything on the right side of the page is right-handed. Ooh, 3:47. You know what? Screw that. Everything I just said is a lie. Not left, the side of the page, right side of the page. I'm just, wherever I see something, I'm picking it up and I'm putting it back down. So this dude has a little bit of these. Let's give him some little underline eye stuff. Let's give him a nose that's about like this. A little honey there. A little creep man style. All right, let's go dark. Before we run out of time on this little sketchy Madu. Sorry, got my 6B on this side. So what I find when I draw with two hands is this one, I push my wrong hand, I push harder onto the paper. So that tells me I'm not quite comfortable. I don't have good control of my pencil, or at least the same kind of control. I'm very tense in my arm. Coloring around little areas like this is harder. And that's what's fun. That's what's fun pushing. Going through that hardness, going through that difficulty is only in those spots do we learn. Only in that time. Let's give him a little bit of eyelashes. Just little itty bitties. Okay, yep, we're looking at 1:25. All right, let's go, scrub, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Gotta speed it up now, feeling pressured, feeling rushed. Which again is fine. Now, if you're, you know, you don't want to do this and making every piece of your art, you don't want to feel rushed. Some things you really want to take your time on and just make into a beautiful piece of work. But when you're learning, when you're trying to grow, when you're trying to get better, try new things. Try new things. Please, try new things. 34 seconds. like giving the fingers a little bit of creativity. There's a shoe here. This guy's power torch. All right, my swift hands, because I got 15 seconds left. I want to make sure everything's erased. You're going to hear the timer go off. There it is. Timer's off. I'm still going, but I'm just filling in this little bit, so that's okay. Again, we're not worried about perfection. I already did what I said I was going to do, which was create a 10-minute drawing. So there's a 10-minute quick sketch. Both hands. That's how it's done, baby. Thank you for listening. Share with a friend. Tell other people. And I hope you enjoy it. I hope you enjoy this content. Thank you. Bye-bye.